I recently obtained a Delta floor model drill press. I can't bolt this to the concrete floor because of the radiant heat pipes in the slab. And where I decided to use it, it sits a bit uneven on the concrete floor, mainly because of that hand-tooled joint in the concrete. It's fairly easy to tip one of these over if you're trying to drill a hole in a heavy piece of material that hangs out to one side of the table. So the side-to-side stability is a little bit lacking. Fore and aft is pretty good. Even the manufacturer recommends that if you don't bolt this to the floor, that you do bolt it to a sheet of plywood, because they're concerned about this drill press tipping to one side or the other. So I decided to make an extended base for this that would increase the stability of the drill press and give me the option for some leveling legs on the four corners. Using a 2x4 frame and lap joints, the center 2x4 will be attached to the drill press base, and the four corners will have leveling bolts. After I had the base built and the drill press mounted to it, it sat quite firmly on the concrete, but the drill press shook back and forth what I thought was excessively. And I blamed that on the flexure in the 2x4s. So okay, I said that was a bad design. I forgot to take a video of that. In any case, I built a new platform. I cut down some 2x6s, used Mathias's box joint jig to do the corners, and the longitudinal supports are held in place by 4 or 5 inch long lag bolts for each one. And I used some Simpson corner brackets to give it more rigidity and support. Covered it with 1/2 inch plywood and gave everything 2 coats of polyurethane varnish to protect it from moisture or anything gets spilled in the shop. Now I have the drill press mounted back on there. This is a very solid foundation, and it picks the drill press up about 5.5 inches. I'm 6'1", so having the chuck and that a little bit higher is a good thing for me. It puts my point of view closer to where the drill bit is going to contact the work surface. However, this drill press is still shaking back and forth. If I push on it side to side, it shakes a little bit. And if I push on it front to back, it shakes a little bit. But the interesting thing is that the base is absolutely solid. If I push this side to side, you can see that bubble dancing back and forth. As I shake that table back and forth, cause it to wiggle, that bubble's absolutely steady. And with the level on the plywood base, when I shake the drill press, again, that level remains steady. There's a lot of weight in this head and in the motor that allows that to shake back and forth. This column is 3 1/8 inch diameter, or about 80 millimeter. But I think where all the movement is, right here in this cast iron thin section where that column adapter bolts onto that cast iron base. But it's solid enough for a drill press. Just kind of annoying when things shake around like that. But it would do that even if it was bolted to solid concrete. So it appears I condemned my first mounting base prematurely. This base is certainly more solid, holds the drill press more rigidly. Box of planer shavings. I found the best combination is to have about 1.5 inches or so of packed sawdust in the bottom. Put the planer shavings on top so the sawdust doesn't get kicked up. And when you're chucking up a good bit, if it gets away from you and falls through this hole in the table, it won't be hitting that cast iron down there or bouncing off of that wood and hitting the concrete. Protect that bit.